Telnet and FTP, you have two protocol that you can use to access the remote devices. But Telnet is not secure. In Telnet, whatever you are sending on the network traffic, that will be visible to everyone. Everyone can see what you are going to send from one device to another device. It is in clear text format. So today we'll do the lab in GNS3 because if you'll use the, you can do in the packet tracer also. But if you want to see what is going on live in Telnet and SSH differences, we can see in the GNS3. And it can show how the password is visible in Telnet, and SSH will encrypt the password, or all information that is sent with the protocol SSH is in encrypted form. In Telnet, that will be totally open and anybody can see what you are going to send from source to destination. So let me open the GNS3. This one is the GNS3. I think I have installed GNS on your system or not?
No, you haven't.
Okay, so I'm going to take a router, two routers here. Okay. Now, I have given the all addresses here, labeled. And first of all, what we need to do, we start all the devices from here. You can see that is the start and resume all the nodes. Yes, it's going to start. So quickly, we need to configure all the devices, router. Then we need to do the routing. And after that, we'll do that. Telnet and SSH, both will configure here. Go on the console. Right click. This is the console here. And the command will be all same that just we have run in the packet tracer. Go inside the configuration mode, config, and the interface is F0/0. IP address is 10.0.0.1.255.0.0.0. And no shutdown.
So that wouldn't be a G.
Sorry?
That wouldn't be a G.
ZNS3. ZNS3.
Okay.
I will install on your laptop also.
Okay.
Yeah. I'll install it. The next interface is INT interface, that is F1/0. And its IP is 192.168.1.1.255.255.255.0. Shut down. So we have configured the interfaces of this R1 with the next. We need to do the routing also. So first of all, we'll exit from here and we'll run the command IP route. And the destination of the other side network is, you can see the other side network is 172, this one. 172.16.0.0. Subnet is 255.255.0.0. And next hop address is 10.0.0.2. press control plus Z to come out from here and write command to save it. So we have done the configuration of R1. Now go on the R2 console, right click here and go on the console. The console is opened here. Conf E, and the interface is F0/0. IP address is 10.0.0.2/255.0.0.0. No shutdown. And another interface is INT F1/0. IP address 172.16.0.1/255.255.0.0. No shutdown. Now we need to do the routing also on this one. So first of all, exit here. IP route destination is 192.168.1.0 and 255.255.255.0 is the subnet, and next hop address will 10.0.0.1. So we have done the routing on router 2 also. Need to save this with the right command. Okay. So both side we have done the routing part. Now we need to configure the IP on this PC1 and PC2. So just right click here and go on the edit and config this one. You can see you just need to uncomment this one. All this part we need to uncomment and get away. Just one cancel and open it again. Okay, so our IP address range we have given is 192.168.1.1. So let me change here, that is say 1. And subnet mask is okay. Then gateway will be 1.1. This one, the gateway will be 1.1. That is okay. 192.168.1.1. 2 is the IP, net mask is 255.255.0 and gateway is 192.168.1.1. Just save it. And once you configure the IP address, you have to once right click here and stop the device and again start it. Right click here, start. Again, go on the edit and config on the other side. And this side IP, we having the 172 range. So first of all, remove this all comments. And change the IP address here. So this side IP address we have given as 172.16.0.2 for this, and the subnet mask we have in the 255.0.0 and gateway is 172.16.0.1. Save it, click on save, then again stop this one and start it again. Right click and then start. So both sides we have configured the IP also. Now we need to check the connectivity. So just right click on PC1, go on the console, and we need to check the connectivity. So what will we do? We just need to right click here. Where is that options? Just click here. Go on the terminal. This is the terminal, and you need to ping the other one. So right click, command ping, then other side IP is 172.16.0.2. Network is unreachable. Why unreachable? Once things, I think it should be the commented on static confusion. So let me write this one. Save and once stop and start again. Then again go here. I think this comment should be also there.
Yeah.
Okay, start getting reply from there. So once let me ping the its gateway first. 192.168.1.1. No, even it is not pinging its gateway. 192.168.1.1. So what is going on inside this? Let me check on the router one first. So IP root. Okay, so root is okay. It's there. And root is working also. We have done wrong in this one. You can see we have define the wrong
one.
Yeah, that is 192.168. That is why it is not working. We need to change this address. Mm-hmm. Go inside the conf mod. And interface is INTF1/0. No IP address. First of all, we'll run the command no IP address. Then we'll run the command IP address and then 192.168.1.1 and 255.255.255. No shutdown. Press control plus set.
Right.
Then again, we'll check now.
Okay.
So, IP interface brief. We'll check the interface addresses. So, now it is 192.168.1.1, right?
Yes.
All right. Now, we'll check here. So, what is going on? Now, it is getting reply. You can see?
Yes.
We need to check for this one. So it is also getting reply. Earlier we have configured the wrong address. That was it is not giving the reply. Now it is okay. So this is just we have done the basic configuration. The main configuration that we want to do is the telnet and SSH. So what is telnet that we need to, suppose you want to access this router from some other location, like this is the location on PC2, you want to access this router exactly. So we'll configure telnet first. Let me go inside the router one and configuration mode conf t. First of all, we'll run the command line console 0. Then password, and let's say I'm giving the password as CCNA. Then we need to run the command exit, and after that we'll run the command enable password, and the enable password also I'm giving the CCNA so that we can remember. So these two password is required first, then we'll create a username and password. Username, and let's say username I am giving here the admin, and the password is, let's say 123. After that, we need to create password for the telnet. So we'll run the command line vty, that is called virtual terminal Yankee. We have two types of terminal. One is the physical terminal that we are using here, and if you want to access the same terminal from the remote location, that will become the virtual. So now we are creating the virtual terminal that I can access from remote locations. So we have the these options that we can create 021869. Means we can create 1869 virtual terminal that can be accessed from remote locations. That is your choice how much virtual terminal you want to create. So let's say me 024. I'm just going to create. Then we'll run the command login. Enter. So it is asking for the where do you want to log in. So let's say login. Then if you put a question mark, we have the option local password checking. So we'll say here local login local. Then we need to say the password. So let's put him password CCNA itself. Fine. So we have done the telnet configuration, and one more command we need to run, input. I think that is transport input. And we have two options, which type of transport input want. So I just want for the, if you want all protocols, or you want the SSH, you want the telnet, whatever you want. So this time I'm just saying all type of input I want. Press Control plus Z and come out from here. Now I have configured telnet on the R1 router, and I want to access this one from any remote location. Before accessing, I'm just going to capture here with the Wireshark. The all traffic will be captured. Start capture. Okay. So this is the tools by which we can monitor what is going on in our network, what is going on the traffics. So let me check here telnet. And going to access on this system. PC2 console and go on the terminal, click here terminal, and I'm writing here command telnet, and the address of the router that you want to access 192.168.1.1. Now you can see it is asking for the user access verification. So it is asking for the username admin and password. What we were given the password 123.
Turbo CCNA.
No, CCNA is the enable password.
Okay.
So now you will enable and it will ask for the password. Enable, then it is asking for the password CCNA. You can see I have logged in on this system. On this system, I am logging on the router here remotely. Let's see. I'm logging here. I can check everything here if you want to check the router configuration. So running configuration. You can see everything you can see here. I'm running the router on the system. This system. Same way we can access, you can do anything. So if you want, you can change the configuration also if you want. Let me change its host name. Go inside the configuration mode, config and host name. So host name, I'm just giving here the router, R-O-U-T-E-R, router. Now it's changed, control plus Z and save it. So whatever we are going to do, everything is visible. If you'll be check here on the Wireshark, this is, you can see.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is going on here. Just right click here on the telnet and then follow. Follow the TCP string. You can see whatever given, you can see here, everything is visible. User access verification, username. We have given the password, admin, you have given, then we have run the all command, that is all visible here. All the traffic is going to, so anybody can hack and see your what you are going to do. So we have just captured the traffic and I can see everything here. So this is the vulnerable point and this is the vulnerability inside the telnet. That most of the network doesn't prefer the telnet because in telnet everything is visible. What about the password? What about the username we have given? You can see everything here. This is the problem with the telnet. So that's why we use the SSH. SSH is the secure cell that will be all traffic will be sent via the secure cell. So let me show you the configuration of SSH also. Just quit this one, exit. Right, close this one. And now I'm going to configure SSH on the router one. Go inside the configuration mode again, conf-t. And for configuration of SSH, we just need to do line VTY024. Transport input we have already done and the login already done. We need to now generate a crypto key. Crypto key generate. This crypto key will be the command that will encrypt all the traffics. But before doing that, I think we need to do the some command for the yes. We need not here, we just go inside the crypto key, crypto, then key generate, crypto key generate, and we have the crypto key of RSA. This is the crypto key that we need to generate. Please define a host name other than the router. Okay, so we have to define the host name because we have just changed the host name there. It is showing router. So let me say again its name as a R1 router. Then we need to run this command crypto key generate RSA. But before generating this key, you need to define a domain name also. So we'll write here IP domain name IPDOMAIN domain name, and you can give the any domain name like abc.com and whatever. So let's say abc.com. So that my domain name I'm just given, and after that we'll just try to show the crypto key generate RSA. So the minimum value of this crypto key should be 512. So that is giving in the default enter. And rest of the command we have already done. The remaining command that we require to access the system, the telnet, intelnet, that is all required. But the main command that we have just run, the RSA. RSA is three, actually, you can say the scientists, they have created this encryption keys. On their name, it was created. Now control plus Z and save it. And then we need to access from the remote location. So how will run and access this? So just go on the other side where you want to access this.
Okay.
Like just we have accessed the, telnet. The same way, we'll go on the any remote location system where you want to access it and run the command. So let me do the same. Okay, again, I'm going on the system. We have this system. This one. Go on the console. This is the terminal. We need to go and run command SSH minus L and then username admin and then IP of the system 192.168.1.2. Okay. So protocol major version 2, version 1. So it have the version of 2 running, SSH version running 2 here on this system. So that is not matching. So we have to configure SSH version 2 here on this router also. So let me configure here SSH version. Conf we have to run this version as SSH 2. So SSH 2 line BTY 024. Let me configure the version, SSH version. We have to show the version 1, version 2. So IP SSH version we have to run here. You need not do this here. We'll run the command IP SSH version 2. We need to configure this one. Please get RSA to key enable. Okay, so we have to increase the bits value also that in the encryption key. You can see that it is asking for at least 768 bit for the SSS. So we need to crypto key generate also, crypto key. Then generate and RSA, and its value must be the at least 768 has been enabled. Let me do it. Let's say 1024. I'm giving here 1024. That was at least it was the morning for the 768. Now press conclude chat. IPSH version 2 we have configured. Now let's try again here. Now the authenticity of the host cannot be established. RSA key fingerprint is this. Are you sure want to continue? Yes. Type yes. It is asking for the password. So what the password we have given there?
It was 123, right?
Yes, I think that. Yes, we are logged in, right?
Uh-huh.
Then enable and enable password we have given as a CCNA. So it is
correct.
Now we are logged with the SSH. So what is difference now? Now see here. Yeah, the SSH traffic. SSH. This is all SSH traffic going on in encrypted form, SSH version 2. And now follow the string. You are follow the TCP stream. What is you can see? You can see anything?
No, it's encrypted.
Oh, yes. All data is encrypted. Nobody can see what is you are sending and receiving on the network. So this right. is the difference between the Telnet and SSH. Sometimes you will be asked in the interview, tell me the main difference between the Telnet and SSH. So now you can see the live, there is a difference. If you are going to configure the Telnet, everything is open, everything is visible.
Other right.
Password, username, traffic, commands you are running. Anybody can access the traffic and see. But in this case, nobody can see what is happening.